My name is Marc Bamuthi Joseph. I am Yannick and Mark's son. I am Makai and Anaya's dad. I'm Kanoilani's husband. I make work in contemporary art spaces, in public spaces that reflects, hopefully, an ethic of collaboration, of interdependence, and of a yearning for collective freedom. As a theater company, we believe in the teachings of the Brazilian educator Paulo Freire, who's a pedagogue that advanced this notion that we essentially can make the world through culture that we want to see. Well, Moving in Passing comes out of a lifelong adoration for global football. It seemed organic to develop something that intersected my many passions, making performance, pedagogical development, the kind of reimagination of American promise, particularly for immigrants and first-generation Americans, to think about how we might use them strategically, kinesthetically, and soulfully in a way that advanced these ideas of what new majority America is becoming. When the Guggenheim Museum approached me about their exploration of social practice work, it seemed like the right time and the right fit. I'm making a piece called Pelota, a soccer-framed freedom suite for stage. It seemed like a great fit for all of us to begin exploring this particular artistic trajectory, these macro political ideas, this specific educational agenda, and this deep love of sport and make something beautiful. But I wanted to enter a more active and participatory theatrical realm. Being in the South Bronx in particular was really magical. The Major Deegan is not just a conduit into the city, but also a line of segregation in the history of the city. There were all these signifiers, there are all these markers of the city that was, of the city that's becoming, but there was no greater signifier of the city that we're becoming than the young people who were all around us playing, who came from, you know, different countries, whose coaches and parents are so invested in their wherewithal. What we're gonna do is we're going to take the drills that their coaches develop for them, and we're going to re-engineer them as pieces of choreography. So all these things provide a kind of locomotive foundation that I then take back to our choreographer, Stacy Prince, and we develop these 8 to 16 count pieces of choreography. We'll incorporate them in a 10-minute performance piece that we'll build in the Bay Area, we'll bring back to New York, and then we'll teach the coaches how we reinterpreted their movements in a choreographic sense. There is a continuum between art making, culture making, and the sport that we love. Everything that you and I might call dance actually has its DNA in the conventional movements on the soccer pitch, and we're just looking forward to seeing the complete cycle illustrated on the field among the young people.